Hi, Stella here. Welcome to part four, I think. I think it's part four. Anywho, it is the final outcome. Okay. Just run through what we've got quickly. Pocket. That's not a pocket. Pocket and a pocket. Room for photos. Put a photo across there. Photos. Photos. Lots of room for photos. What I have done is I've made a photo mat that's going to fit really nicely in here for a nice big photo. Probably a 4x6, I'd say. But that fits in there. And I've done another one. Just a plain one. A little fold out there. And there's a waterfall. I'm sure I did this at the end of the last video, but never mind. Pocket or tuck spot. Plenty of room for photos. In there, pocket in there, and there, and here. So there's plenty of room. Okay, what I'm going to do now is show you what I'm going to put on the front and the back. Let's just lift this up so that it's a bit more. There we go. Okay, this is my front. Am I close enough to it? Let me just up my camera a bit. Sorry about that. Okay, that's our front. Gorgeous. It's more vibrant in person than it is on the screen. On the screen it's quite muted, but the roses here are really pink. And then that is my spine, which is part of this paper, and that looks orange, but it is not orange, it is pink. And that's the back. So, I've already put my tape on. Excuse me. So let's just take off the backing of the tape. Goes that way. So I am going to put just a little bit of glue around the edge all the way. Plus in between. Looks pretty right to me. Hard to see from an angle. Maybe these will show up pink on your screen, but it could just be my screen, I'm not sure. But they are pink, for sure. Okay, let's take the backing off the spine. Stay there. Stay there. Sound like I'm talking to my dog. I get more obedience out of this than I do my dog. That's the right way up. Where's my glue? And we are going to put glue again. Tape alone doesn't really do it for me, I have discovered. I do like the addition of glue. Okay, settle that in the middle. Down a bit. Oops, over there. That looks about right. And this is plain enough that it could use some embellishment if I choose. Okay, the front. Upside down there. I have to stand up for this, otherwise it will be crooked. Have I got up there? It looks okay down here. Looks okay up there. Okay, we've got some embellishments and some stuff. We've got some nice tags, etc. I've got some embellishments here. I'm not sure what I'll use. Plus, I've got some papers printed out. I love this. I was going to put this on the front. And on the back like that. Then I changed my mind. That bit there looks like the devil. Don't like that. So I'll cut that away. This is pretty, pretty, pretty. Again, pink. But on the screen, it looks like it's peach. This beautiful cottage there. Pink flowers and the faded rose. Okay, let's look in here. I don't think this needs anything on it. Perhaps something like beauty is in the little things. Or it could be a little tuck spot there. Yeah, I'm not inclined to put anything on those ones, but I am inclined to put this one in. Just a little tuck. Beauty is in the little things. And I will cut out one of these papers and put a photo mat in there. To leave quite a few pages alone for large photos, so I'm going to leave that one. Okay, what I've done for this one, I've done these, cut out some of my roses, back them on the white cardstock, and I'm going to put them on here somewhere. I was thinking one there and one perhaps there. But having said that, that might get in the way of popping a photo in there. So we might just put one. See what else I've got. I'm just going to pop this rose there. Just about halfway down, perhaps. And just there. Okay, we've got some tags. Those three in there, and then I'm going to get a photo mat for this part here. Oh, I've also got some flowers, flat flowers. I rather like it. I like the colours. I could go with this, my faded medieval rose. Oops. Rather like that. And it's got the foam there to lift it up. So I'm just going to put a bit of glue on that because I don't trust the foam glue. And then we'll put it just there. And think we can tuck a photo mat in there. Okay, we'll come back for the photo mats once we've decorated little bits and bobs. I think I'd like to put a photo mat in there. Okay, we've done this one, which is good. We've done that one. This is a bit plain, so let's stick another flower in there. How much space have I got there? Not enough. That's all right, my thought process is all over the shop. I'm going to put it at the side there. I am going to back these with cardstock, and I might go for some different colours too. Okay, so that's that, and let's put another one over on this side. So I have to take one of these off. Damn it. You have to put something small on there. Well, I messed that up, didn't I? Just messed it up. Oh, I like that one. I'm going to put it that way, I think. Or not. Maybe up that way. There's no planning in this, there is just do, guess and do. And here I have another one. Cute. Cute. Okay, now that's teaching me. I cannot put flowers where I don't have a decent enough gully or gusset. Same thing on this one, unfortunately. Oh dear. Oh, I could do it flat without the upper thing. Take that foam off. Why didn't you think of that, Stella? So pretty, so pretty. Okay, flat, almost. So I've got a little bit of a bump, but it's still within. Our quarter inch gusset there. So that's cool, that's fine. This keeps getting stuck on there. Don't need anything here. I'll put photomat in there. Over here, there's plenty of room to put something pretty there. Okay, where's my leaves? There we are. So I'm going to put my leaves there. Just hold them a little till the glue dries a bit. Okay. I don't like that dark leaf there. So I'm just going to take it off. I love this little flower. So sweet. So let's put that one in. And cover the stem of the leaf. She takes forever to make these little flowers. I'm always reluctant to use them because it takes so much time. Okay, but they are beautiful and actually worth the trouble it takes to make them. So we're going to put a little bit of blue in there as well. Just tuck it in there. Like that. Okay, we need photo mat there. So between those spaces, I can put some height with the flowers. Okay, what do we got here? Photo mats, and I might leave that one plain, and that one. Okay, this envelope needs a photo mat there, and one here. On the front, we're going to put something. And we've got a space, we can't put much, so let's go something from here. Nope. One of these? Yeah, let's put one of these on. Just going to make little measurements here. Where's my pencil? Come to me, little pencil. Nope, we'll use a pen. No, we won't use a pen. Maybe we will. Can't find it. Oh, there it is. It's hiding. Okay, so I'm just going to. That's the width. Probably we'll do it a bit shorter than that because if you're adding a photo, you need some wiggle room. So that's what I would do it as. And for the width. Probably that much. Okay, it needs to be bigger. It's okay. This one will go in there nicely. Okay, let's put let's put a little nice corner on it. That's nice. Rectangular ones, what's that? No squares, but I like that. I do like that. We can do just a little bit of inking around here, but not much. I don't want to overload it with inking. Just a little. Now I am going to put this one on. I like that. And then the other side is for a photograph. Find out where my magnets are so I know where I'm going. I've got these sweet little stickers, but I don't think they'll go with this. What we just want is in there, I think, and excuse me, oh, yeah, I like those two in there, but I am going to back them with the white cardstock. Oh, I've also got this little note thing. Pop that in there. Okay, let's get some oh, doesn't that look nice? Or that one. Whoever is happy will make others happy too. Yeah, I'll put this one in. Now matting your pictures, making your mats is purely a personal thing. So you mat the way you want for the photos that you want to put in. Right, let me get a sheet of paper and we'll start some matting happening. Okay, I'm using 200 GSM, which I have used throughout. Except once or twice I've had to use a scrap of the 300 GSM. Okay. That cottage there. I'm not paying any attention really to actual photo sizes, because you can, you know, when you go to the photo shops, you can actually change the sizes of your photos and you can trim them, etc. I'm going to have an eighth of an inch, if that, around here. Too much on that one, so take a smidge off if I can be allowed to do that. Yep, just a little hair. And I do like to round the corners, but I haven't rounded the corner of that, so I'm not going to do it. So I'm going to pop this in there. There it is. Jeez, that's gorgeous. Okay, nothing else for these. Do you know what? I'm going to put some flowers on that one because I've got room. I am going to put something here. Not that. I like these two. And a leaf. We'll get back to that, otherwise I'll get distracted. Okay, that piece we cut off, I'm just going to glue these and pop them in. That'll fit sideways really nicely. Probably could just take a gentle corner.
Yep.
Just a gentle corner. And this one the same. This cut off. You can do as many photomats as you like. Okay, I'm just going to take a little smidge off the side. Trim, trim, trim. Still a bit more. Good grief. This one smaller. Love these. These are brilliant. Got these from Temu. No, I didn't. Tell a porky. I got these from AliExpress. But it works out if you get them from Temu. It's cheaper. Because for two of them, I paid $10.93, I think, for postage. Which I nearly cried at. Postage these days is absolutely horrendous. I guess that's why the world's gone brisk for Temu. Free postage for everything. Okay, I've got two. One more. This is such a pretty picture. I printed it on a piece of satin and I made a cushion, and that's what that is. We will just gently. Whoops. I guess you really are supposed to look at it from upside down. Okay, let me show you where they go. Wasn't here, was it? No. It was in here. One. Two. And three. Now I'm going to do a larger one. Just grab the ruler. Just pop it in there. I think it goes as far as 10, so I can go 15 centimeters. Let's go 6, 6.5. 6.5, maybe about 4.5. Okay. That's too small. 74. Okay, let's have some yeah, I'm going for that, I think, for that patchwork piece. So we're going with 4 and 1, 2, 4 and 3/8. 4 and 3/8 by 5 and 1, 2, 3/8. Hopefully. Not 5 and 3/8, 6 and 3/8. You silly bugger. When you use printables that you print out yourself, make sure you don't get any water or liquid of any sort on it, because it will run. As you probably saw when I was sorting out one of the pages earlier, taking off a flower, it ran. Take long for that glue to dry, and here we've got some unglued piece, so let's get in there with the glue and sort it out. Seriously? Come on. certainly prefer it when you get a little bit of glue squeezing out, because then you know that you have got right to the edge. Okay, there's that in there. Gorgeous. Okay, now what do we want? Okay, first we want something that's going to go into this. Let's see what we've got here. This piece is a bit too big. Pretty good. Let me see if I can stretch this just a little. That's good. Okay, what can we put on there? This piece. Or let's take off an eighth of an inch here. Good, but I'm just going to take a smidge more off that side. And let's put some Weird and Wonderful corners on it. Oh, isn't that pretty? Look at that. Same with this. I need to get one of those little vacuum cleaners that will pick up all my little bits of snippy paper. Well, that's going to be gorgeous. Yeah, very happy. Okay. Room for photo on that side or that side, whichever. Where was I going to put this? I'm going to pop that in there. Here we go. Right. That could be a photo. You can put two photos here, or just one large one. And this doesn't have a backing, so we're going to put a backing on that one. trim it first. That's the same one that I just used, so I had thought about using the 300 GSM cardstock for the photo mats, but then I thought, well, you've got to put photos on those mats, so best not make it too thick. So that's why I went for the 200. The 200 GSM is, I don't know, is it 85 pound or something like that? I'm really not sure, so don't quote me on that. But it's quite sturdy. One I like to use when I'm making my flowers. Either the 200 or the 176 GSM. One or the other. If you're in Australia, you can get the 176 in Spotlight. In the 12 by 12. This one goes in there. Okay, back to this. What else are we going to do for this one? Oh, we've got that one in there. We need one for here. Okay, let's look at that. And we might make a tall one, so let's go 2 there. Good. Okay. I'm gonna go with this lady. So I'll just put some marks on here. I might do a small framework around it. That mark and that mark. And that's what we'll cut. Perfect. That's beautiful. Perfect. Might go for, I like to make things different, let's go for that one there, that one. That's nice. And same with the photo. pretty okay. I glued that whole thing down, didn't I? So that needs a bit more decoration. Or not. Nope, little one goes up first. That's that one. Okay, we need one that goes in here. What I first want to do is, this is a little envelope, and I got the envelope die from Temu. So I'm going to do something with this. I'm not quite sure what that little hole means. Let's just put these together and see what happens. This one's smaller. Look how easy it is to fold these. Aren't they cute? I love cute. Okay, I'm thinking that would go in there like that. I like that. That's too big. No, you don't need anything else on these. Where can we put them? We wanted to put something else on here, didn't I? I'm going to put that there. But it's just so cute. It's not a tuck spot as such, it's just a decoration. Okay. So close, 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 and close. Okay, back to this one. To need another piece of, here we go, we've got a scrap. I this one could probably go 7. Okay, 7 by 5. There's plenty of room for a 6 by 4. Let's see if it fits before we get too enthused. Oh, it's a tight. It's tight. So even with a photo in there, it's going to be tight. Let's see if we can stretch this paper just a little without cracking or breaking. No, I'm not going to use that. So I'm going to take 1/2 inch off each. Half an inch off the 7-inch one and make it 6. Let's see how that goes. That's much better. Okay, let's put some of this in. I like this area here. Oh, I love it all, but I'm thinking this area. Oh, I didn't trim that properly. Yeah, I like that on there, so let's pop that there. Vacuuming to do for all those bits of paper. It's not a bad fit, but that's a little bit long. Take off about a 1/16 of an inch, I think. See if that makes a difference for us. I'm inclined to just take a snip off the side here. Blade is becoming a little bit blunt, so when that happens it pays to just burnish your edges. So let's just go with a real pointy. Hard to see sometimes. Oh, I love this piece. Love this piece. Gorgeous. Woohoo, woohoo. Up, up, up. That's the way. Facebook. Where did we want this? Oh, in there. Gorgeous. Okay. Yeah, I think this corner here just catches on that. So I'm just going to take that little corner off on both sides. Hoping that'll work. Okay, that's all we need on that one. Now we could use some more, but no. Don't overdo. Love this. Okay, let's go. We might go with this way, and we'll try that size first. Let's see if that fits. Oh, that goes great! Great, great, great. I thought I was cutting cardstock. Huh. Well then. Now let's see what measurement this is. Almost 5 by almost 7. Excuse me. Let's grab another piece of paper. I bought the wrong paper. Well, that's not quite true. I bought the right paper, but wrong pack. I bought this one from Officeworks. And this was 25 sheets for $23.98, I think. And I meant to buy the 100 sheets for $34, I think. So do the math, I'm out of boo-boo. So let's take a little smidge off this one. So, yeah. What a mistake to make a... What should we do here? Something pretty, or I kind of like this one. It's really nice. Yeah, so if you do the math, that $23 by 4 is a hell of a lot of difference. So if you're in Australia and you're looking for this kind of cardstock, go to Officeworks or Officeworks Online, whatever, and look for quill A3 board teachers. Teachers resources or teachers something. It's a teachers pack anyway. And I obviously didn't look in all their pages online. Okay, are we good? Are we good? Lovely. Okay, another one pretty much the same size as this one. Yeah. I did 5x7, didn't I? Okay, so we will go a little before 5. And a little before 7. Fingers are starting to hurt now. Arthritis, it lets me play for a little while and then it says, you gotta quit, you gotta quit, you gotta quit. There's not much spacing on this one. So I haven't inclined to, well, now that I've cut the corners, I'm not going to change it. I'm not going to change it. So we're going to be pretty lean with it. A little bit over. A little bit over still. Come on, a bit more. A bit more over here, thanks. If you don't mind. Thank you. Thank you. lovely. Already got one in there, that's good, that's good. Okay, I've done some tags as well as thingies. Oh, got another little envelope there. Okay, I'm going to put these tags on paper, on cardstock first before I go anywhere else. And then we'll trim glue. I'm going to have to re-punch some holes here. I'll just trim this up a bit. Rather than get the big gun out, I will just use this one. There we go. That's one. Oops. These little tags, they're good for journaling and putting notes on about your photographs. And these little tag dies were from Temu and they cut perfectly, absolutely perfectly. Oops. Okay, is that all I've got? Just three tags. Oops, there's a little one. Itty bitty. you don't have to back them like I'm doing. You can just, if your cardstock is thick enough, your pattern paper, if it's thick enough, you don't need to do this. But I printed mine out on the 200 GSM, so we're just getting some extra thickness here. That's okay. Okay, now I've got these little safety pins. So cute. Cute. Okay, so I'm going to put all these tags. 2, 3, 4. Put them together. Now, I want to put them somewhere. So we can't put them on there, there's not enough room. There's plenty of room here, I can put them here. So what I am going to do is I'm going to punch a hole just about, maybe up there a bit, just there. You've got it upside down, Stella. No, you haven't. Ow. It's a bit thick, that's all. Okay, and then we're going to put this safety pin through there. For our tags. I love the safety pins. Still got to do this. We're not finished here. We're not finished. I want to put that somewhere. Where can I put that? I can have a tuck in there. Just across there. That should be enough. Okay, so now we have to put a photo mat in there. Stick. I don't think I need to put a backing in this, but I am going to round off some corners here. Oh, I do like to put backings on them. Okay, once this one is done, I'm hoping I get the things I need for my baby's first Christmas. I'm so looking forward to doing that one. Was it? Oh yeah, still haven't done these. Oops, there's another tag. That's really pretty. Do some trimming. Let's just make this 4 and 4.5. And what's that? 4.5 square. See what we can do with it. Square is good. Just go in from there. And we're definitely going to round this one off. Let's go with the 10 millimeter. space. These ephemera pieces are from a totally different range of papers. Bought ones, not ones I did myself. Do something here. Another one. Let's go. That's a good size. This is from some paper I bought, which I have used to design or create my own version. That's good. Let's go again with the rounding. We're going to go with the 10mm again. It's a nice large rounded corner. Whoops, which one do we want? I think we want that one. More to do here. So I'm going to go with just taking a rough estimate here. Fits beautifully. So let's do one with that lady. Oh, what have you done, Stella? Oh, okay. smidge off the side. And again, we'll go the 10. In there beautifully. Okay, so these three pieces, we are going to back them. It's getting close to dinner time now. Okay, one more. Oh, won't go in there either. That's too close. Okay, just grab the scrap. I keep all my scraps, even my box board scraps. Our three little tags in there. Just one more. Too wide. Okay, let's go with maybe there. Still a bit wide. Take off a quarter inch. You have to account for not only the cover paper, but for your photograph. I'm going to put this around on there. Where did you put it, Stella? Seriously? There it is, right in front of my nose. the right way up, or?
Yep.
Okay, I would like to put something here, but it's going to have to be something real thin. Real thin. Oh, that's pretty. That lace is pretty too. There we go. Okay, let's just see how we're going. That's the last page. Need anything on there, I don't think. Or here. Photos. I'm just looking for my magnets. Yeah. That got a little thing in there. Photo mat in there. And that one. And those. It's from the same piece of paper. I love those little envelopes, they're so darn cute. That's good, that's good. So they go in, it doesn't matter which, but seem to want to go that way. And then we've got three and picture mat in there. And photos. And oh, I love that photo. That picture, sorry, went together well. Okay, now I saw something in my floral book here that I wanted to use. Medieval rose. Not sure if that's the one. Only thing is, it's a red rose and I've got pink. Medieval rose. Oh shoot, patootie out of me. Not can't really do that medieval rose because medieval rose really is a red rose. So I don't think we can put that on there, much as I would love to. But I chose that, so we could put that. Oh, we got another one of those. We could put that. Or I could just stop playing with it. There's also that. I could stop playing with it. No. Stop playing with it, Sarah. It's perfect as it is. Okay. That's it. This beautiful album. I think the only place that could go is there. We'll think about that. I was also going to put a couple of those in, but no, decided against that. So that's what we've got. We've got what we've got, and I'm happy with it. I'm very, very happy with it. And if you know me, you know that I just keep going and going and going. And where'd you come from? In there. Stay in there, lovely. I tend to sometimes just go too overboard and put too much in it, but this is just perfect as it is. It's gorgeous. Okay, thank you very much for being with me. I've taken up so much of your time. It's taken me hours and hours and hours to do this. Oh look, I also wanted to put my gold and pearl beads in there somewhere. Stop. You've got to stop somewhere, haven't you? You really have. Okay, I'm stopping now. Thank you very much for being with me for this journey, and I hope you like the album. And don't forget, check out Shelley Geigel's YouTube for all the information on this album. That's where I took the info from. Okay, thank you, and I'll see you next video. Bye.